Hello students, good morning. This is Manjula S, Assistant Professor in Commerce, Government College for Women, Kolar. So today we are going to deal a subject called Commodity Market for 4th Sem MCOM, Bangalore North University. Okay, so in this continuation of the previous video, so we are going to concentrate in today's session as commodity exchanges in the world. Okay, so now we'll move on to the content part. So commodity exchanges in the world, most commonly, and one more thing, in the previous session itself I have briefed out which are the commodity exchanges are there in the world. Okay, and what are the commodity exchanges are there, so where are it is situated in the world. Through map I have shown you. I hope you have understood with the concepts. Okay, so continue to that. So most commodity markets across the world trade in agricultural products and other raw materials like wheat, barley, sugar, maize, cotton, cocoa, coffee, milk products, pork bellies, oil, metal, etc. And the contracts are based on them. These contracts can include spot prices, forwards, futures and options on futures. So here I have told you that all the products including agricultural commodities are also traded in the commodity exchanges. So many of the commodities which are traded in the agricultural market and commodity exchange I have specified in the previous video also. So there are many products, and also these are other raw materials which are traded in this, so that like wheat, barley, sugar, etc. Many are there in our food related products or commodities. Okay, so those products are also traded. So it is based on the contracts, which is based on the contracts, and it also includes spot prices, forwards, futures and options. So I have specified about these four concepts in the previous video only. Okay, so based on these prices the agricultural commodities are traded. Okay, next, the economic importance of commodity market across the globe. So what is the, because whatever we trade, whatever we do the business, whatever we exchange, so everything will be based on the economic importance only. Okay, so without economic importance I think we never do any business. ಓಕೆ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಥರದ ಆರ್ಥಿಕ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಇಲ್ದಿರಾ ಅಥವಾ ಆರ್ಥಿಕ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ದಿರಾ ನಾವು ಯಾವುದೇ ಥರದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಸಣ್ಣ ಟ್ರೇಡು ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ. ಎದರ್ ವೆಜಿಟೇಬಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆರ್ ಎದರ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ವಿ ನೆವರ್ ಡು. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಸಮ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ರಿಟರ್ನ್ಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈವನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೋ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಗೋ ದ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಿಂಗ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ಇನ್ ಟರ್ನ್ ಇಟ್ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ನಾವು ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ನಾವು ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಏನಿರುತ್ತೆ, ಒಂದು ನಮಗೂ ಅದು ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಅದರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಅದರಿಂದ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಗೂ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್, ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಸಮ್ ಮೆನಿ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಟ್ರೇಡ್, ಸೊ ಮೆನಿ ಕಮಾಡಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ ಆರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆಟ್ರೋಲಿಯಂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ನೈಮೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ನ್ಯೂಯಾರ್ಕ್. ಸೊ ಪೆಟ್ರೋಲಿಯಂ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ನ ನೈಮೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ನ್ಯೂಯಾರ್ಕಲ್ಲಿ, ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಟ್ರೇಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಕಾಮೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ನ್ಯೂಯಾರ್ಕ್. ಸೊ ನಮಗೆ ಈಗ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್. ಟುಡೇ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್, ಟುಡೇ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಬೈ ಸೋ ಮನಿ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಟ್. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸಿಬಲ್, ಎಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್, ಟುಡೇ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ನೋಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡೇ ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡ್ಯೂರೇಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಕಾಮೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ ನ್ಯೂಯಾರ್ಕ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಪರ್, ನಿಕಲ್, ಎಕ್ಸೆಟ್ರಾ, ಅದರ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ LME, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲಂಡನ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಚುವೇಟೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಲಂಡನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾಫಿ ಬೀನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಫ್ಲೂಯೆನ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ LIFFE ಲಿಫೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ICE ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಲಂಡನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಟ್ಲಾಂಟಾ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೈಸಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಡಿಟರ್ಮೈನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ದೀಸ್ ಟೂ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ prices of rubber influenced by Tokam, that is in Tokyo. So Tokam, it is the exchange name and it is situated in Tokyo. And the prices of agricultural commodities are determined by Cobalt, that is in Chicago. Okay, so whichever the products we wanted to trade, so those trading and those products price fixation and those products trading activities, everything will be done in this Cobalt, that is in Chicago. Okay, so this is what about the economic importance. Next, so commodity exchanges in the world. So other sophisticated products may include interest rates, environmental instruments, swaps, or ocean freight contracts. So many commodities are there in the world, that's what I told. And that so even the ocean freight contracts, so environmental instruments, so these are also being included in the commodity exchange. The many and the most important international commodity exchanges, I think this we have discussed in the earlier video also, like Cobalt, CME and LME, and NYMEX, Tokom, DC, that is Chicago Board of Trade, Chicago Mercantile Exchange, London Metal Exchange, New York Mercantile Exchange, Tokyo Commodity Exchange, Dalian Commodity Exchange. So these are all the important international commodity exchanges which takes parts in the world. Okay, so note down, students, that even for abbreviation of any of these will be asked in your examination. Okay, next. So this is Cobalt, Chicago Board of Trade. So Cobalt is a place which is there for commodity exchange. As early as 1840s, Chicago Board of Trade was formed to trade in grains. The Cobalt established in 1848 and is the world's oldest future and options exchange. Okay, so Chicago Board of Trade, that is Cobalt, it is formed or it is established in 1848, which trades what? Grains. So which trades grains, and it has world's oldest, so oldest futures and options exchange have been taken place and have been started in this Cobalt. More than 50 different options and future contracts are traded by over 3600 Cobalt members. So we have 500 different options and future contracts which are traded. So 500 different options and future contracts have been will trade in this commodity exchange, that is Cobalt, and over 3600 Cobalt members are there to trade these activities. Okay, next, continuation of this. In 1864, the Cobalt listed the first ever standardized exchange traded forward contracts, which were called future contracts. So in 1864, the Cobalt listed the first ever standardized, that is exchange traded of what? Forward contracts, which is also called as, which were called at that time was future contracts. So forward contracts have been called as future contracts in at that particular time, that is 1864. In 1919, the Chicago Butter and Egg Board, a spin-off of Cobalt, was recognized to enable member state to allow future trading, and its name was changed to Chicago Mercantile Exchange, that is CME. So in this 1990, the trade members were allowed for future trading. So the members are allowed for future trading, and it is recognized, and even butter and egg also have been add on to this what we call commodities. And in this, the main name of Cobalt have been changed to Chicago Mercantile Exchange, that is CME. Okay, so CME is the revised name of Cobalt. Okay, so that is Chicago Mercantile Exchange. So Chicago Mercantile Exchange, or CME, is an American financial and commodity derivative bay exchange based in Chicago. So okay, that is an American that is a financial and a commodity derivative exchange. So commodity have been traded in this, and it is based in Chicago. The CME was founded in 1898 as the Chicago Butter and Egg Board. Originally, the exchange was a non-profit organization. The exchange demutualized in November 2000, went public in December 2002, and it's merged with Chicago Board of Trade in July 2007. and become a designated contract market of CME Group Inc. So it is founded in 1898, and it includes butter and egg board have been included. It is a non-profit organization. Andre ee Chicago Mercantile Exchange anode enide 1898 ralli established matte adralli butter matte egg board add agide ajothege it is a non-profit organization. Non-profit andre nimage gottide which doesn't expect a profit, okay, and it is demutualized at the in the period of November 2000, and it went to the public in the 2002. It merged with which board? Chicago Board of Trade, okay, in 2007 to become a designated contract market. So to become a designated contract market, it has merged with Chicago Board of Trade in the year July 2007. Okay, in August 18, 2008, shareholders approved a merger with the New York Mercantile Exchange, that is NYMEX and COMEX. So in the year 2008, that is August 18, the shareholders approved a merger. Merger, I think you are aware of merger. It means two companies come together, join together and do the business. That is a merger. So here, NYMEX and COMEX have been merged in the year. So that is the shareholders are approved to merge in the year 2008, that is August 18. The merger Cobalt, NYMEX and COMEX are now markets owned by CME Group. So it is a market owned by CME Group. So Cobalt, NYMEX and COMEX, they have merged. These are the mergers and they have formed markets. It is owned by CME Group. So this comes under CME Group, which we are discussing now. And CME Group exchanges offer the wide range of global benchmark products across all major asset classes. So now CME become a group and Cobalt, NYMEX, COMEX have become the parts of those CME Group. Okay, so it has covered a wide range of global benchmark. So it has have the major assets across the world. Okay, next. So this is various participants: red jackets, light and dark blue jackets, green and gold jackets. So these are the members who act or interact in the CME Group. I think you have seen this. Okay. So what are those red jacket, blue, green? We will discuss later. Okay. See, in the 1919, Chicago Mercantile Exchange have been established. In 1961, a frozen pork belly future contracts, that is I think you have aware of business of this is what we call the meat, that is pork belly, that have been traded, that is also a commodity which can be traded. So that has to be is traded through frozen. You cannot trade it as it is. Okay, frozen pork bellies can be traded. In 1961 it is started. And next, that is why it is being made, because you know China people most concentrate on these type of products, and they are used to make bacon. So that is just made up of this pork bellies. Okay, and in 1964, live cattle future contracts. So this is the first future contract to be based on non-storable commodity. So you know what is cattle. So even cattle also can be exchanged in this, traded in this. So but it is called live cattle. It cannot be stored as these products, as other commodities. It cannot be stored and traded. But these only can be traded in the live. So you know, I think you have aware of sante. Sante anod gottide nimge. ಮೊದಲಿನ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಥವಾ ಈಗಲೂ ಇದೆ, ಹಸುಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಣಿಗಳನ್ನು ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಸಂತೆ ಅನ್ನೋದಿತ್ತು. ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನೋದಿರಲ್ಲ, ತಗೊಂಡೋಗಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾವು ಅಂಗಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾಳೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ತಂದು ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾರೋ ಥರ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಅವರು ತಗೊಂಬರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ರೇಟ್ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಅನುಕೂಲ ಆಯಿತು ಅಂದರೆ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೋಗ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಆ ಥರದ್ದು ಈವನ್ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜಲ್ಲೂ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಅದನ್ನು ಲೈವ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ, ಲೈವ್ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಅಂತ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಥರ ಸ್ಟೋರೇಜ್ ಇರೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹಸು, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಕ್ಯಾಟಲ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಇದ್ದರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ತಂದಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ಬೋದು, ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು, ನೀವು ತಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬೋದು. ಅಷ್ಟು ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಯು ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಇಟ್. ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಯಾರೋ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಮೀಡಿಯೇಟರ್ ಬಂದು ಪರ್ಚೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮತ್ತೆ ನಾಳೆ ರೇಟ್ ಬಂದಾಗ ಸೇಲ್ ಮಾಡೋದು, ಆ ಥರ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ನಾನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರಬಲ್ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ 1972 ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಫಿನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ 7 ಫಾರಿನ್ ಕರೆನ್ಸೀಸ್. ಸೊ 72 ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಯಿತು, 7 ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯ ಕರೆನ್ಸಿಯ ಮೂಲಕ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಇದು ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಯಿತು. ಸೊ ಆ ಥರ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಕರೆನ್ಸೀಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷ್ ಪೌಂಡ್, ಕೆನಡಿಯನ್ ಡಾಲರ್, ಡೆಸ್ಚ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್, ಫ್ರೆಂಚ್ ಫ್ರಾಂಕ್, ಜಪನೀಸ್ ಎನ್, ಮೆಕ್ಸಿಕನ್ ಪೆಸೋ, ಸ್ವಿಸ್ ಫ್ರಾಂಕ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕರೆನ್ಸೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ 1975 ದ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್, ಇನ್ 1982 ದ ಇನ್ನೋವೇಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈವನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1975 ಫಾರ್ ಇನ್ನೋವೇಟಿವ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂರೋ ಡಾಲರ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್, ಬಿಕಮಿಂಗ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಸೆಟಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ರಾದರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ದ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಡೆಲಿವರಿ ಆಫ್ ಅ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಯೂರೋ ಡಾಲರ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಯುರೋಪಿಯನ್ ಡಾಲರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಟ್ರೇಡಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ದ 1981 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಸೆಟಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೀನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಟು ಸೆಟಲ್ ಇನ್ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್ ರಾದರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಡೆಲಿವರಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಮಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ವಿದೌಟ್ ಫಿಸಿಕಲ್ ಡೆಲಿವರಿ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕಮಾಡಿಟಿ, ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆನ್ ಸೆಟಲ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾಶ್. ಇನ್ 1982 CME ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ 1982 ಇಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಸ್ಟಾಕ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ 1982 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ 1984 ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಲಿಂಕ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ 1982. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೂ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ಸ್ ಅಟ್ CME. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 4 ಡಿವಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ CME ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್ಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ CME B1, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕೋಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಟು ದ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್. ಇಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ಸ್ ದ ಎನಿ CME ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ಎನಿ CME ಲಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್, ಸೊ ಕೋಬೋಟ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ಜ್. ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್. ಸೊ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ಜ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಕಲರ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಮಾನಿಟರಿ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ IMM, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಕೋಡ್ ಗಿವನ್ B2. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರೇಡರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫಾರಿನ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್, ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ರೇಟ್, ಈಕ್ವಿಟಿ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್. ಸೊ IOM ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೆಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ IOM ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೆಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಗ್ರೀನ್ ಕಲರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ IOM B3 ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ಸ್ ಇಂಡೆಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ರ್ಯಾಂಡಮ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್, ಆಲ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಜೆಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ಟ್ರೇಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ IOM, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ B3. ಸೊ ಕೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ B3 ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ಜಸ್ ಬ್ಲೂ ಕಲರ್. ದೆನ್ ಗ್ರೋತ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಮರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಜೆಮ್ B4 ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಟ್ರೇಡ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಎಮರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಾಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಮರ್ಜಿಂಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್. ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ರಿಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ಜಸ್ ಗ್ರೇ ಕಲರ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್, ಎಲಿಜಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಟು ಬಿ ಆನ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ CME, ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಆನ್ ಅಡಲ್ಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪೊಸೆಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ರೆಪ್ಯುಟೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರಿಟಿ. ಇನ್ ಅಡಿಷನ್, ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಡಿಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಟು ಅಸ್ಯೂಮ್ ದ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಿವಿಲೇಜಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಶಿಪ್. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ CME? ಸೊ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಎನ್ ಅಡಲ್ಟ್, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಮೈನರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ರೆಪ್ಯುಟೇಷನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಂಟಿಗ್ರಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಡಿಕ್ವೇಟ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ನೋ ದಟ್ ಎನಿ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಎಂಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್, ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೈನಾನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್. okay, to take the responsibilities and privileges of the membership. So you should have some response. If you enter as a member of that CME, you have to bear some responsibilities and privileges will be given. To bear that, you need the some eligibility qualities. So next is corporate. The standard corporate membership for banks, hedge funds, commodity brokers, etc. So that is corporate also membership for banks, it is given. So hedge funds, it is an investment which is made by the client, and that money will be invested in the alternative investment. So that is called as hedge funds. And the commodity broker, so this is what the membership of, which are the parts of this corporate, that is banks, hedge funds and commodity brokers are available to corporate in this CME. And next is electronic corporate, that is corporate membership designed to benefit fund firms that conduct large amount of trading using the CME Globex system. So Globex system is an electronic corporate which is used to benefit the firms in large amount of trading. Next is clearing. Highest level of membership for large organization that plays a clearing role, that is underpinning transactions in the Chicago Mercantile Exchange, that is CME. So highest level of membership will be given in this CME for large organization, and that plays a clear role in the CME. Okay, next, the trading hours. The normal trading session unique for each futures contracts, though generally sometime between 9 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Central time, that is GMT 6 hours. Exchange trading session, that is 9:05 a.m. to 4 p.m. with Friday close at 1:30 p.m. So this is what the trading hours for the CME, that is 9 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. that is general central time, 6 hours. And electronic trading session will be 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. and Friday it will be close at 1:30 p.m. Okay. The next is NYMEX, that is New York Mercantile Exchange. So here the most actively traded commodities are palladium, platinum, coal, propane, natural gas, uranium, crude oil, electricity, gasoline, heating oil, aluminium, copper, gold, silver. Okay, NYMEX will trade all these commodities. Okay, so some of our metals and some of our the energy and some of our rare metals. Okay, next is its regulatory board. The floor of NYMEX is regulated by Commodity Futures Trading Commission, an independent agency of United States government. So it is an independent agency of US government. It is being traded the commodity futures trading, and it is a Commodity Future Trading Commission, and it is an independent agency, that's what I told. And it is under the, and that is what NYMEX is, the floor that is regulated by Commodity Future Trading Commission. Okay, Commodity Future Trading Commission will be headed by this NYMEX, and it is an independent agency which runs by US government. Next, continuation of it. So commodity exchange began in the middle of 19th century when businessmen began organizing market forums to make buying and selling of commodities easier. By the late 19th century, about 1600 marketplaces have sprung up and ports and railroad stations. So before, that's what we know about the barter system. Before that too, before centuries, we never used this market system or this trade or something. Okay, in the middle of 19th century it started, and it has been made by market forum for buying and selling of commodities very easily. But the late 19th century, they have started 1600 marketplaces at ports and railroad stations. Okay, you know, we have four ways of transport. So, but at that point of time, 19th century, only waterways, railways and roadways have been started to trade or to do the commodity exchange. In 1872, a group of Manhattan dairy merchants got together and created the Butter and Cheese Exchange of New York. So, in 1872, even the dairy products have been came into existence. So, that is Butter and Cheese Exchange. So, they have created Butter and Cheese Exchange in New York. In 1882, the New York Mercantile Exchange was opened for trading in dry fruits, canned goods, and the poultry. Okay, in 1882, so one by one, the products or commodities have been added to the commodity exchange. So dry fruits, that is, you know what is dry fruits? Those are all also added to this canned goods. That is, it has been protected or preserved in the cans. So those products. And also poultry, hens or eggs, like that. In 1933, the commodity exchange was established through the merger of four small exchanges: the National Metal Exchange, the Rubber Exchange of New York, the National Raw Silk Exchange, and the New York Hide Exchange. So these are all the four commodity exchange have been established through the merger of with COMEX. COMEX jote ee naalaku exchange merge aitu yavaga 1933 alli. On the August 3rd 1994, the NYMEX and COMEX finally merged under the NYMEX name. So even in 1994, NYMEX and COMEX have been merged. Okay, they merged and the name is given only NYMEX. Okay, so next, Dalian Commodity Exchange. So this is the next commodity exchange, that is DCE. It was established in February 28, 1993, and since the establishment it has been an important player in the production and circulation of mainland soya beans. So when it started DCE, at that particular point of time only it started working on soya beans, and soya beans was an important player in the production and circulation. And DCE earned a reputation among investors for its financial integrity with prudent risk management and great market functionality in international price correlation, transparency and liquidity. Okay, so it earns a very good reputation among the investors on the basis of financial integrity related to risk management and great market functionality and with the international price correlation. Okay, so here it also concentrates on transparency and liquidity. So this is what the parts of that DCE to get its good reputation. So it works best on these concepts. So it has got a good reputation. And next is Shanghai Metal Exchange, Dalian Commodity Exchange, Zhenzhou Commodity Exchange. The number of future contracts was cut back further to 12 from 35 and more brokers were closed. Okay, so Shanghai, this is the three commodity exchange. So they have cut back the many products. So many products was being traded at that particular of time. So they have cut back. That means they have deleted many of the products and it have come down to 12. And many of the brokers are also closed. So because brokers are the people who trade the transactions. Next, margins were standardized and regulations further toughened. Trading on foreign future exchange was further restricted to a small number of large global entities. Soya bean, soya meal and beer barley was traded at DC. So here, after this reduction of the commodities, and it has been standardized very much, and regulations have been very toughened at that time. And the trading of foreign further exchange was still more restrictions have been added. Inash to Katina Danta restrictions in add Martha Bandro. Adadmele, it's small number of large the global entities to again. It traded the soya beans, soya meal, barley, and was traded in the DC. So these are the products which has been traded in the DC. On July 17, 2000, DCE restarted trading soya meal, the first product listed since the last listed rectification of China's future exchange. Until 2004, soya meal futures have been one of the most rapidly developing future contracts at China's future market. Okay, in the year July 2000, so DCE restarted trading soya meal. So restarted in the year 2000, and the first product listed since the last listed rectification was China's future exchange. And in the year 2004, the soya meal futures have been one of the most rapidly developing future contracts. So soya meal is a commodity which has a rapidly developing future contract have been included, established by this soya meal at China's future market. So that particular country. Okay. So next is about tokam. So tokam, this is, I told you, that is Tokyo Commodity Exchange. This is there in also Tokyo. It is established in Tokyo. It is a non-profit organization and regulates trading of future contracts and option products for all the commodities in Japan. Okay, the Tokyo Gold Exchange, the Tokyo Rubber Exchange, the Tokyo Textile Exchange merged into in 1984 to form Tokam. Okay, so it has gold exchange, it has a rubber exchange, and it also has a textile exchange. So these three have been merged and it become the Tokam, that is Tokyo Commodity Exchange. Okay, commodities traded, so which are the commodities traded in Tokam? That is metals like gold, silver, platinum, aluminium and palladium. Okay, oil, that is crude oil, kerosene, gasoline and rubber. And it is an open outcry of, it is the oldest and the most popular way of trading on the exchange. It is central to the process of price discovery. Prices are derived from the most liquid periods of trading, the short open cry ring trading sessions, and are most representative of industry supply and demand. The official settlement price on which contracts are settled is determined by last offer price before the bell is sounded to mark the end of official ring. So as usual, we know how the trading takes place. So here it also concentrate on process of price discovery, and the price will be derived on the liquid periods of trading. So liquid periods, and in this here the representative will be made on the both supply and demand concept. As usual, all the business will do. And the settlement price will be based on the bell which is rang before the official ring, sorry, at the end of the official ring. So you know that when you bid at the time of the business, bid will be done. So at that time, the quotation of lowest price for a product will be given the order or what you call the tender. And so and for that thing, even here also it is determined by the last offer price. The last offer price will be where, that too before the bell is sounded. So before the bell is sounded, which will be the last offer price, that will be marked as the price in this token. Okay. So we have come to an end. Okay. So now we have come to an end of this session. Dear students, I hope you have understood with the concepts. So kindly comment me whatever it is there in the content which you couldn't understand or could understand. Okay, if I get some comments related to this, so I hope I can manage or I can change whatever it is required. Okay, so I hope you have understood the concept, students. And so again, I am telling, stay home, stay safe. So take some healthy measures and protect your health. Okay. So thank you so much.